Hello and welcome to this Warcry Catacombs painting video. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint your Khainite Shadowstalkers up to a battle-ready level. Now, the model we're going to concentrate on is the Shroud Queen. However, by following this guide, you can easily paint the other members of her warband. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, we've gone with Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be applying. Now, we're going to start by applying a couple of base coats. The first base coat we're going to be using is Rakar Flesh, and this is for the skin. After that, we'll be using Barrignar Burgundy for any burgundy leather areas, and then we'll be using a Baden Black. This is in preparation for parade-ready levels, such as the cloak, the shadow effects, the gems, and her blades. But first of all, let's start with Rakar Flesh. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette, like we do with any kind of base coating, and then just a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. As you can see, it moves around quite freely there. So the next thing to do is just make sure I get my brush to a nice point, because we're going to be getting into like obviously some detail areas here. So once that's ready, let's start getting those bits of flesh done. So I'll start on the hand first and work my way around. Now I should go over in one coat with a grey undercoat, but you might need to do a second coat in some places. There we are with the Rakar Flesh now applied and dry. We're going to move on to painting the corset and the little sash around the waist with Barrignar Burgundy. So take your time, and again, you might want to do a couple of thin coats of this. There we are with the burgundy done. What we're going to do now is move on to applying a Baden Black. So there's a couple of areas to focus on here. You've got the weapons to do. This is in preparation when we start turning them into like jade weapons. You've also got all this shadow effect, which is like the whole kind of like wispy cloak that follows around. This weapon here, and then you've just got a couple of gems hanging from her ears as well. So what I'm going to do is just take our time and just base coat all these with a Baden Black. There we are with the Baden Black now base coated. What we're going to do now is move on to applying the rest of the base coats. We're going to start with Iron Hand Steel. This is going to be for the armor plates, but on some of the models in the warband, you'll need this for the blades as well. After that, we'll be using Retributor Armor for any gold details, and then we're going to finish off by picking out the straps with Corn Red. But first of all, let's start with picking out those armor plates. So as always, just a little bit on the old palette, a little touch of water, and we're ready to start base coating. So on some of the models, it will vary from model to model, but mainly they tend to have knee pads and van braces. So just keep an eye out, check the box art if you're not sure. There we are with the silver now applied. I've also done it on the face mask here as well. So what I'm gonna do now is move on to Retributor Armor. So there's quite a few little bits to pick out. So you've got the crown, you've got the trim around the armor, trim around the van braces, and then other little details here and there. Again, if you're not sure, just check your box. There we are, those gold areas now picked out. We're going to finish off by applying Corn Red. So we're looking for weapon hafts and little bits of banding on the weapons. Take your time, just build up those layers. There we are, those red details now done. We're going to move on to applying some contrast now. We're going to start by using Gullum and Flesh. This is going to be for the flesh areas, but also the gold details as well. After that, we're going to move on to Black Templar, which is going to be for all the black leather details like the boots, the trousers, but also going to be using it for the hair too. After that, we'll use Basilicane and Grey for the silvers, also the burgundy and the red. Then we'll finish off by picking out that faceplate with a little bit of Ethematic Blue. But first of all, let's start with the flesh. So what I'm going to do is just load my brush up, apply a little bit like that, try and get a nice point, and then we're ready to start on both the gold and the flesh areas. I think I'll start on the flesh first and then work my way up. There we are with the Gullum and Flesh dry. What we're going to do now is use Black Templar. This is going to be on the hair and the leather. So that's the boots and the trousers. So again, just take your time. And if you do find it pulling, just use your brush to soak up any excess. There we are with the Black Templar dry. What we're going to do now is move on to using Basilicane and Grey. And this is going to be concentrating on any areas that are silver, burgundy, or red. There we are with the Basilicane and Grey now done. We're going to finish off by painting the visor using Ethematic Blue. So again, just be mindful of it not pulling too far at the bottom. Just one coat should be enough. And there we are with the contrast stage now done. What I'm going to do now is move on to basing the model. And for this, we'll be using Mordant Earth. Now I'll be using my trusty texture tool. And I'll start with a large scoop side first. So what I'm going to do is just scoop some of that out of the pot like so. And then we're ready to start applying that to the base. So what I'm going to do is just dollop it around here like so. And then I'm going to move to the smaller side. This is for more accuracy. And then start moving that around. Now, once this starts drying, it will start to crack and give this nice arid earth kind of look. But obviously, it's black, so it's like almost volcanic. So that'll take about an hour or so for that to start happening. Once that's done and dry, you just need to paint the rim of the base, and I'll pick a colour that matches your warband. For this one, we're going to use a Baden black. And there we are with the texture dry and the rim of the base painted. Our Shroud Queen is battle ready. Now at this point she does look quite dark because there's lots of blacks on there, but she is from the realm of shadow and she is in preparation for her parade ready steps. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point. Also, when using contrasts or shades, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Khainite Shadowstalkers, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.